remember when the family was everything. Oh, do you remember?
My name is Priscilla Mecklenburg. I'm Haitian, and I'm African, German, French, British, and Indian. Because I'm mixed, I have different views, and people don't understand that because I speak differently. I speak three different languages, and I have different leaders that have influenced me compared to how an African American, what their leaders were. I wasn't really influenced by that because even though I've heard about it and I've learned that in school, but that doesn't mean it influenced me. I joined Kappa Chi, Kappa Delta Chi, which is a Hispanic sorority. And why I joined it was because I relate a little bit to Hispanics because we were influenced by Hispanic cultures in Haiti. And people always tend to put me down because I did that, because I didn't join a black sorority. And they always ask me if I think I'm Hispanic or something. And that shows me how people view people that are different and mixed, because I did something because I was comfortable, and I felt like me joining Kappa Chi was a way that I could relate to people of my own culture because I relate to them, and it's like I felt comfortable.
Kind of looking for blackness was a big part of my high school, middle school life. Besides spending most of my time with, you know, mixed friends, black and white friends, and, you know, any other mixture beyond that, it was always, where do more black people spend their time in my neighborhood, because it's not at my house or the places I've been to. Or, I mean, I had friends of many different races, but I kind of wanted to find me at the same time. And it was, I don't know, it was a kind of weird journey to take.
My husband, who's Caucasian, and I were up in Spokane, and we were somewhat confronted by three African-American males. Two of the African-American males ended up cornering my husband, and the third African-American male came over to me and started to ask me, what's up with this? And I'm like, what are you talking about? And he's like, what's up with this? And he pointed towards my husband and then at my stomach, for which I was pregnant about like 6 months at the time. And he said he didn't understand why I had to go and do this to him and to other African Americans. And I don't know, going through that experience, it shaped my relationship towards other African Americans. And I started to distance myself from a part of my heritage just because of the negative experiences I've had. As I began to attend the University of Idaho, I came across more African Americans that were around my age, and I guess it was just from the transition, but then I was able to become more comfortable and realize that the experience I had were somewhat subjective, you know. Unfortunately, those people that I had those experiences with just had a negative spin on what being black is, or, you know, what entails, you know, what black folk should be into and not be into.